This is the story of the disc-shaped UFO during Apollo 15 mission on the moon in 1971. Did Jim Irwin and David Scott really film a UFO on the moon's surface? Were astronauts warned to leave the moon? Hi everyone, what's up? I am GH, aka Dose Geek, back here with you and Section 51. This is completely crazy. Watch this Apollo 15 video footage, which could be showing a saucer-shaped UFO hovering over a crater, apparently observing two moon-walking astronauts.
That's over yours. What's that? I'll get this glass ball here on the... No, why don't you save it? Let's document it.
Okay, circle around it. Okay, I'm gonna move out and get the contingency sample.
Roger, Jim.
Out of the
push
now, Joe.
Roger, Jim, we copy that. And did Dave get your UV visor down?
Yep, he did. TV's coming off to go to the tripod. Hey, you're looking even in the media.
The famous Apollo 15 video was uploaded to internet on April the 5th in 2015 and raised the possibility that it was an advanced spacecraft monitoring the Apollo mission. Whistleblower and astronaut testimonies have revealed the Apollo 11 mission was monitored by two spacecraft hovering over a crater, allegedly giving a warning to NASA. The spacecraft may have been extraterrestrial in origin. Another more intriguing possibility is that the Apollo 15 UFO belonged to a highly classified space program, again warning Apollo astronauts and NASA from future moon missions. I am a little shaken by this information. I must admit that I didn't see it when it was published in 2015. But is it real or not? Now I'm curious. Like you, I want to know. So, what was Apollo 15 mission? Apollo 15 was the first of the Apollo J missions capable of a longer stay time on the moon and greater surface mobility. Apollo 15 was the ninth manned mission in the United States Apollo program, the eighth to be successful and the fourth to land on the moon. There were four primary objectives falling in the general categories of lunar surface science, lunar orbital science, and engineering operational. The mission objectives were to explore the Hadley Apennine region, set up and activate lunar surface scientific experiments, make engineering evaluation of new Apollo equipment, and conduct lunar orbital experiments and photographic tasks. The crew was composed of David R. Scott, commander, James B. Irwin, lunar module pilot, and Alfred M. Warden, command module pilot. Changes to the Apollo spacesuit and to the Portable Life Support System, or PLSS, were evaluated, and performance of the lunar roving vehicle and the other new J mission equipment that went with it, Lunar Communications Relay Unit, or LCRU, and the Ground Control Television Assembly, or GCTA. The mission began on July the 26th of 1971 and ended on August the 7th. The lunar surface exploration taking place between July the 30th and August the 2nd. The mission accomplished its goals but was marred by negative publicity the following year when it emerged that the crew had carried unauthorized postal covers to the lunar surface, some of which were sold by a West German stamp dealer. In fact, before the flight, the crew had made a deal to carry postal covers to the moon in exchange for about $7,000 each, which they planned to set aside for their children. The members of the crew were reprimanded for poor judgment and did not fly in space again. Apollo 15 is also remembered for the finding of the Genesis rock and for Scott's use of a hammer and a feather to validate Galileo's theory that absent air resistance, objects drop at the same rate. But years later, in 2015, Apollo 15 became famous again thanks to a rather incredible video revealed to the public. And what is surprising is that it seems to be an original footage from the NASA archive. In the video, astronauts Jim Irwin and David Scott are on the moon's surface. Scott is heard giving commentary as he films Irwin and the surrounding terrain. Scott sweeps through an area showing a white floating saucer-shaped object apparently hovering over a crater's rim. His first comment when seeing the object is to say "whoops" at 2.02 minutes and to then pan away. Scott focuses the camera on the ground, which is curious given the strange hovering object near a crater. His whoops comment and immediate panning away suggests that he is deliberately trying not to focus in on UFO. Nevertheless, the camera sweeps past the object several times without stopping or focusing on it. This leaves the viewer wondering why he ignored the strange white object. Scott's behavior raises the possibility that he was under orders to ignore the UFO and instead film more innocuous features of the moonscape. Was his curious filming behavior a result of some warning NASA had received concerning the Apollo program? A possible answer emerges from events associated with the 1969 Apollo 11 moon landing. After the arrival of the Apollo 11 lunar module on the moon's surface, there was an alleged radio transmission from Neil Armstrong during a mysterious 2 minutes of radio silence. In the transmission, Armstrong said that there were giant UFOs hovering over the horizon watching the moonwalking astronauts. According to Timothy Good, author of Above Top Secret in 1988, ham radio operators receiving VHF signals transmitted from Apollo 11 to NASA's Houston headquarters intercepted the following message, which NASA screened from the public.
What's there? Mission Control calling Apollo 11.
These babies are huge, sir. Enormous. Oh God, you wouldn't believe it. I'm telling you, there are other spacecraft out there lined up on the far side of the crater edge. They are on the moon watching us.
Maurice Chatelain, a retired NASA communications engineer who helped develop the communications system used in the Apollo moon missions, said in 1979 that Armstrong's sighting of two UFOs over a lunar crater was being deliberately kept from the media and public by NASA. The encounter was common knowledge in NASA, but nobody has talked about it until now. So why did NASA eventually terminate the Apollo program if advanced spacecraft were already there and watching the landings? The answer, according to Armstrong, as relayed by an unnamed professor at a NASA symposium, is as follows. What really happened out there with Apollo 11? It was incredible, of course. We had always known there was a possibility. The fact is, we were warned off. There was never any questions then of a space station or a moon city. How do you mean warned off? I can't go into details, except to say that their ships were far superior to ours both in size and technology. Boy, were they big and menacing. No, there is no question of a space station. But NASA had other missions after Apollo 11. Naturally, NASA was committed at that time and couldn't risk a panic on Earth. But it really was a quick scoop and back again. If NASA was indeed warned of the moon, then subsequent missions such as Apollo 15 only went forward as a public relations exercise to avoid a panic on Earth over the early termination of manned moon missions. The saucer-shaped UFO filmed by Apollo 15 may well be an advanced spacecraft there to monitor the Apollo mission and to give a firm warning to NASA to put an end to the program. If so, was the UFO extraterrestrial in origin, or is there another more conventional explanation? Recently, two whistleblowers have publicly emerged, revealing the existence of secret space programs with bases on the moon, and we ever talked about one of them here on Section 51. Yes, Randy Kramer and Corey both claim that they were first taken to a secret base on the moon in 1987 as 17 years old, where they separately began 20 years tours of duty with their respective space programs. They called the secret moon base Lunar Operations Command and claimed it is used by personnel belonging to secret space programs and visiting extraterrestrial spacecraft. In an email, Corey claims that Lunar Operations Command began to be built in the late 1950s over an abandoned moon base. If Corey's and Randy's testimonies are accurate, Lunar Operations Command was already in operation during the Apollo moon landings from 1969 to 1972. According to Kramer, in early 2014, he received orders from his military superiors in a covert branch of the US Marine Corps to reveal the existence of secret space programs taking place on the Moon, Mars, and elsewhere in our solar system. In September 2014, Corey publicly emerged claiming that he has been contacted by a relatively new group of extraterrestrial visitors that are facilitating public disclosure of secret space programs and visiting extraterrestrial life. Corey claims that one of the secret space programs, Solar Warden, is part of an alliance of secret space programs and visiting extraterrestrials to disclose the truth to the world public. Most startling is his claim that among these space aliens are members of between 5 to 7 ancient human civilizations that have their own ongoing space programs. The Apollo 15 video of a saucer-shaped UFO on the moon may be hard evidence of an advanced spacecraft monitoring the moon landings. Scott's strange filming behavior was likely due to orders he received as a result of a warning delivered to Apollo 11 astronauts. The craft associated with the Apollo 15 video and the original Apollo 11 radio transmission by Armstrong may not have been extraterrestrial in origin, but instead belonged to a secret space program that did not want NASA to establish a permanent presence on the moon. As a primarily civilian agency, NASA's presence threatened to expose the activities of one or more secret space programs and or extraterrestrial civilizations on the moon. This is especially plausible if a facility such as Lunar Operations Command was already in operation. I don't know what to believe, although the video seems authentic. We are living in a time of confusion and misinformation everywhere. Maybe the recent Chinese missions on the moon could help us to find some pieces of truth. Once again, if these pictures are real, it seems that NASA was warned against continuing the Apollo program in 1969 and astronauts from subsequent landings were told not to film anything that might reveal artificial structures on the moon or advanced spacecraft monitoring the final Apollo missions. However, one thing is clear from the Apollo 15 video. A strange white shape appears in the background, and that UFO appears to be monitoring the moonwalking astronauts. The key question is, does the UFO belong to extraterrestrials, a highly classified space program, or an ancient human civilization? Or is it anything else? Thanks for watching. Please like and share our videos and subscribe to Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.